the phones, you can be able to detect and see where probably they end up. Yeah, so the tools, there's Google, you can use Google image search. So this is Google image search. So there's a tool here, search by image. You can do a reverse image search. So this is like uploading. You can either paste the URL of the image or download and upload that image. And then it will tell you, it will show you where this image has appeared before. So that's what we call a reverse image search. So that's how Google works. And when we do these trainings, we do a bit, I think we'll do one once I've shown you the other tools. So this is, that's how it works. And most search engines, there's Bing by Microsoft, there's one called Yandex, is Russian. Russian is very good with facial recognition. So you want to see someone, there are images of people, you can use Yandex to do a reverse image search and to see if there's something that has occurred. And then there's one called TeamEye, this one. So it's TeamEye.com, and it does the same thing. You can upload or you can paste the URL to see if that image has been used before. So you'll find that sometimes Google will find that image and TeamEye will not. Sometimes TeamEye will get or Yandex will get. So it's sometimes good to use all the available tools that are there. And there's an easy way to do that. So there's this photo here. This, I think, was fact checked by the Standard, the Canuses. And they were showing this lady was running the Olympics or preparing for the Olympics when she was 7 months pregnant.
Yeah.
Did you see this?
Yes.
And people were publishing it and forwarding it and, you know, saying, wow. But there's a way to check if this image has been used before. So if you can download the TeamEye, there's a TeamEye plugin. So plugins are usually found here. You can download plugins. And it can help you to verify. So if I right click on this image, like this, and use TeamEye, this one is TeamEye, it can ask me, I can use all search engines to verify, or I can pick any of these. So that's the good thing with TeamEye. So if I pick all search engines, I want to do a reverse image search. So it opens in all the four search engines. So like this one, this is Google reverse image. Now you can scroll down. The thing with this, you have to scroll down and you can start seeing the prevalent runner was Alicia Montano, and it had been published in 2014. This Bing, you can scroll down also. There's Yandex, it's Russian, also the same thing. And there's TeamEye. The good thing with TeamEye, you can sort it by when was it first published. So the oldest image, you can select the oldest image here, and it will tell you that the first image that of Alicia Monsanto was June 27, 2014. So you have done a reverse image search using that tool, and you can quickly do it using TeamEye. Yeah, so let me give you a task as we are almost wind up. So there's this URL. If you can type this URL on your browser and then do a reverse image search. So this image, first type it either on your browser or you can use a laptop. Okay, most people didn't come with a laptop, but you can use your phone. Terry, are you not able to see it? This one, number two. Type that URL. Sure. Are we there? So if you're there, that image was published by, was posted on Facebook, I think in November. When was Ruto in Kisumu? Was it in November?
Mm.
October, I mean. And the person said that that's one of the images that were there in Kisumu. So we want to verify, when was that image first published on there? When did it appear online? So we want to verify if actually that image has been used before.
Do you need to add Kisumu?
No, I don't add Kisumu. Just, that's the URL. You can use any of the... Anyone?
Yeah.
Which year? So that's what you should be seeing.
Yeah.
So that's not what you're saying?
Huh? Yes.
Okay, so when you do a reverse image search, either Google or TinEye, you can take the same URL and post it on TinEye.com or any other thing TinEye doesn't have. You can try here. So now that I have the TinEye plugin, I can do a reverse image search with all the search engines.
It shows different days. To 2009 and 2019.
It shows 2009 and 2019.
For music, that's for dinner.
Sorry?
It's dinner.
Yeah.
So, you are from 2009?
Yeah.
Okay, that's 2009, November 8th should be. Yeah, but it's actually, 2009. 2009 should be the first time it was published, and you can see that it was published. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's how you use the reverse image search. If you're on mobile, I'll recommend this tool, because sometimes you may not have access to your mobile. You're out in the field, and you're getting content and you're not too sure about it. There's, I don't know if people know about Google Lens.
Google Lens.
Yeah, Google Lens. You can download it as an app on Play Store. I think it's also available on Apple Store. Mm-hmm. So Google Lens, it also does the same thing, but the good thing, let's say you're putting an image on WhatsApp, you can use Google Lens to go open your WhatsApp files and select a particular image and do a reverse image search. So Google Lens is good at that, and you can use it on mobile. So you can download that and see how it works. It also has other functionalities, like if you see a flower and you don't know the name of this flower, just take a photo to search, or anything, any search, and then it gives you something similar to that. So that's Google Lens for mobile. Alright, so that's how you do Google, you do reverse image search. There's also another tool called InVid. InVid is very analytical and uses data and a very specific way of searching. You can use it to see if an image has been manipulated or if it has been used before. You can use it also to do reverse image search for video. So this is also a plugin, you can use that. So quickly for video verification, almost the same process as image verification, but first, just using your journalism skills, read the comments. I think the users also have it. I can see sometimes they say, no, this didn't happen here, this happened here, or this was not what has transpired. Then you can quickly do a quick Google search or news search or YouTube search to see that event happened. And then there is what I just explained in terms of InVid. You can use TweetDeck search if you're on social media. TweetDeck search. I'll send the resources, yeah, and YouTube GeoFind, which I'll explain. Yeah, so that's video verification. This is the tool.